Airway management is a process used to ensure that a patient is able to breathe and perform gas exchange. It involves suctioning, airway maintenance, establishing an artificial airway, and extubation. It goes without saying that this is a very important topic in the field of respiratory care, which is why we created this video to provide a brief overview of this topic and break it down in a way that's easy to learn and understand. So, if you're ready, let's get into it. So, what exactly is airway management? As previously mentioned, airway management is the process of maintaining ventilation so that gas exchange can occur. This allows a patient to take in oxygen while removing carbon dioxide. This is important because we need to keep a patient's upper airway free and clear of foreign substances so that air can flow into and out of the lungs. There are quite a few types or procedures that are considered to be types of airway management, including the following: endotracheal suctioning, sputum sampling, artificial airways, intubation, emergency surgical airways, securing the airway, confirming proper tube placement, secretion clearance, tracheostomy care, troubleshooting airway emergencies, and extubation. Again, these are examples of the common procedures that are involved in the process of airway management. Respiratory therapists are involved in every step of the way, which is why this is such an important topic. So, what is an artificial airway? An artificial airway is a tube that is inserted into the patient's trachea in order to maintain breathing and ventilation. This is necessary when a patient is unable to maintain their own airway or if they are at risk of aspirating. In this case, an artificial airway is used to establish a link between the patient and the mechanical ventilator. There are three primary types of artificial airways: endotracheal tubes, tracheostomy tubes, and pharyngeal airways. Each type has different uses and advantages. However, in order to function properly, they must be inserted and maintained correctly, which is the job of the respiratory therapist. An endotracheal tube is a small, flexible tube that is inserted through the nose or mouth into the trachea. This is necessary to establish an artificial airway or a patient in need of mechanical ventilation. The endotracheal tube is secured in place with tape or a tying device, and the insertion process is known as intubation. A tracheostomy tube is a small flexible tube that is inserted through an incision in the neck into the trachea. This is generally done when a patient is unable to tolerate intubation or if they are in need of long-term ventilatory support. After a tracheostomy tube has been inserted, it is the responsibility of the respiratory therapist to maintain the tube in place and keep the incision site clean. This is known as tracheostomy care. Pharyngeal airways are small tubes used to prevent obstructions, and they extend only into the pharynx. There are two types of pharyngeal airways: nasopharyngeal and oropharyngeal. A nasopharyngeal airway is a small tube that is inserted into the nasal passage of patients who require frequent nasotracheal suctioning. An oropharyngeal airway is a small tube that is inserted into the mouth of an unconscious patient to prevent the tongue from causing an obstruction. A key tidbit to remember about these airways is that the oropharyngeal airway can only be used if the patient is unconscious. If the patient is conscious with an intact gag reflex, an oropharyngeal airway would be contraindicated. Switching gears just a bit, now let's talk about intubation. Intubation is the process of inserting a tube into the trachea in order to establish an airway and facilitate breathing support via mechanical ventilation. This creates a link between the patient and the ventilator so that gas exchange can occur. During an intubation procedure, patients are administered anesthesia and a muscle relaxant in order to minimize discomfort and relax the muscles of the airways. A laryngoscope blade is used to open the mouth in order to visualize the vocal cords. Then a flexible plastic tube is inserted through the patient's mouth or nose, through the vocal cords, and into the trachea. The tube can be secured by inflating a small cuff that surrounds the tube with air in order to provide stability and help keep it in place. The process of intubation is typically the same in patients of all ages. The only difference is in the size of the equipment used during the process of insertion. For example, pediatric patients will require a much smaller endotracheal tube than adult patients. Male patients may sometimes require a larger tube than female patients. The physical insertion of the endotracheal tube is a procedure that requires a trained or skilled professional. which is why it's most commonly performed only by doctors and respiratory therapists. Next, let's talk about airway suctioning. Airway suctioning is the process of clearing secretions from a patient's airway. This is typically done using a suction catheter, which is a thin, flexible tube with a small opening at the end. The catheter is inserted through the nose or mouth and down into the airway. It uses negative pressure from a vacuum source to suction and remove mucus and secretions. Suctioning is an important part of respiratory care as it helps to keep the airway clear and free of obstructions, so that breathing can occur. It is performed on a regular basis, mostly by respiratory therapists, but nurses are involved with suctioning as well. And that leads to one of the final steps, which is extubation. In general, intubation and mechanical ventilation are only temporary for most patients. Therefore, at some point, the artificial airway must be removed, which is the process known as extubation. The decision to extubate a patient is based on many factors, including their ability to protect their airway, adequate respiratory function, ability to manage secretions, adequate oxygenation, stable hemodynamic status, and their ability to cooperate with the medical team. The respiratory therapist or physician will generally perform the extubation procedure. This involves oxygenating the patient, deflating the cuff, removing the tube, suctioning secretions, and assessing and closely monitoring the patient. As you can see, airway management is very important, which is why you must develop an understanding of artificial airways, intubation, endotracheal suctioning, and extubation. Hopefully, you can use this video along with other resources on our channel and website to make the learning process much easier. But again, for this video, we just wanted to provide you with a brief overview of airway management. We'll be diving deeper into each of the subtopics that were mentioned in separate videos. But real quick, if you don't mind, do me a huge favor and hit the like button. It really helps support the channel and I greatly, greatly appreciate it. And you might as well go ahead and subscribe for more videos like this. Hopefully what you learned in this video was useful and can help you develop a better understanding of this topic. If so, be sure to let us know down in the comment section below. And if you want to learn even more about this topic, we do have a full guide on our website. I'll drop a link to it right below this video down in the description. Thank you so much for watching all the way to the end. Have a blessed day, and as always, breathe easy, my friend.